Cheers. What's up, guys? My name is Ryan, and I recently turned to Australia to come on this, and I want to share with you some favorite places to hear the Australian talk. Home to some of the world's most beautiful and diverse landscape, from the pristine beaches of Esperance to the tropical island of Port Hedland, Australia is ready to be experienced. With such to be awesome, Tasmania, most of the half of Australia's southeast coast, Tasmania is an island home to some of the most beautiful beaches in the world. It's a beauty and culture in the world, and I'm really glad that you're here. One of the beauties of the world is here to take you to the world. You can see the island of Tasmania, and the by a 10-kilometer hike, but we decided to take the boat going out of Cape Way. We just found how to get there, and the views are really, really amazing. Once we reach Cape Way, I was amazed by the sea on the right and the sea cliffs, and it's such a spectacular day. After, we're going to head to the mainland to visit Western Australia. Before I came to Australia, I thought it was my dream to go to a road trip across the country in a year or two, before I realized there was a 40-hour flight. So, the car flight is definitely a faster option, but if you want to do a week or two road trip, it would be an incredible drive. Now, the capital of Western Australia is Perth, which is the fourth most beautiful city in the country. What happens to you about Western Australia? The beaches are home to hot sand, crystal clear waters, and continues to chain on the beaches. The area around Esperance is super beautiful. It's home to some of the hottest sand in Australia and the world. Really the beauty of the especially with my friend, work with Tom for sharing his footage in Australia. He makes great videos of Australia, and I link his channel in the description so you can check him out. One of my favorite beaches in Esperance is Highland Beach. It's located 10 minutes outside the town of Esperance, and it has this massive rock on the top of the hill, and it's massive and different. Another beautiful place in the area is Cape Grand, and it's the same coastline as the beach. The most iconic landmark in the Outback is Uluru or Peter's Rock. It's a massive monolith made up of sandstone. You can reach the area by flying into the nearby town of Ulara, or also by making the 4-hour drive from Alice Springs. Now Uluru is a sacred site for the indigenous Australians, and it's believed to be a resting place for ancient spirits. There's definitely an energy there, and it's just bizarre how it sits alone in the desolate Outback. Afterwards, we're going to head over to Brisbane. Located on the east coast, Brisbane was founded in 1824, and today it's the third most populous city in Australia and the capital of Queensland. It's a beautiful city built on the Brisbane River and has an average of 260 days of sunshine per year. Just an hour from Brisbane is the Gold Coast, which is this incredible city with a huge beach contrasted with skyscrapers. If you want a more natural setting, you can embark to the Glasshouse Mountains. Located about an hour's drive from Brisbane, the Glasshouse Mountains are a group of 13 volcanic peaks. They are some of the most peculiar mountains I've ever seen, and the tallest is Mount Birrwhite with an elevation of 556 meters. If you want to see them from the air, you can take a similar plane tour to witness this. After we're going to visit Whitehaven Beach, regularly voted by one of the best beaches on the road, Whitehaven Beach is located on the Whitsunday Island. You can reach it by taking a boat or sea boat. The boat tour is the most affordable option. Thank you. It's home to over 10% of all ocean fish species, and it's at 21%. The potential city to act as the great runner from these caves is located near some of the most powerful rivers and islands of the river, and you can reach it by taking a 40-minute boat ride from Paris. Afterwards, you'll be fast forward to the city. Located about 3 hours back, beach and has some really cool pools alongside the ocean. Just down the coast is also Bronte Beach. It's smaller than Bondi Beach, but has its own charm, and there's this really cool public pool called Bronte Baths that you can get in if you don't want to swim in the ocean. A beautiful place outside the city is the Blue Mountains. They are located about an hour and a half drive from the city. This is a beautiful mountain range that has a famous distinctive color due to a combination of caves, coral droplets, river forests, and huge green rainforest, creating a blue hue. A great lookout point in the mountains is from the Three Sisters. It's only a short walk to the lookout, and you get a beautiful view of the lookout and the mountains in the back.
Charming hillside, amazing views of Paris, popular spot. famous love that you never started. You once destroyed a broken heart that was over and shattered. And holding on to what we have, it takes us to the edge and back. Holding on to what we have, it takes us to the edge and back.
Underground Paris by visiting the Catacombs of Paris, a shadow land of underground tunnels and galleries underneath busy Parisian streets. The ossuary known as the Catacombs date back to the 18th century when the remains of over 6 million people were moved into underground tunnel networks of former stone mines to reduce the growing number of cemeteries in Paris. Walk through the tunnels, you will see the sign of the streets you are under, as well as the names of the original cemetery locations from where the remains were moved. Number 4. Eiffel Tower. Eiffel Tower is one of the most recognized world attractions and most visited state monuments in the world. Including the tip, Eiffel Tower is 1,063 feet tall and is the tallest structure in Paris. It was constructed in 1889 by the company owned by the engineer Gustave Eiffel as the entrance to the 1889 World's Fair. It was originally supposed to be demolished after. It was initially met with criticism from many famous Parisian artists. The tower offers 3 floors, and to reach the second one, you can even climb the 674 stairs if you don't feel like taking the elevator. Did you know there is a small secret apartment at the top of the Eiffel Tower? It was built by Eiffel for himself and to entertain the science elite such as Thomas Edison. Number 5. Museums. Paris is home to over 100 museums. The most famous museum in Paris is Louvre, which is the world's largest art museum, featuring a permanent display of the most famous world artists, including Leonardo da Vinci's Mona Lisa. Luxury shops, theaters, and cafes. Champs-Élysées is the location of the annual Bastille Day military parade and the finish line of the Tour de France cycling race. Before it became a fashionable avenue in the late 18th century, the location was mostly occupied by fields and gardens. At the west side, Champs-Élysées ends with Arc de Triomphe, commissioned by Napoleon in 1806 and inaugurated in 1836, dedicated to the armies of the Revolution and the Empire. Beneath the arch, there is a Tomb of the Unknown Soldier, added in 1921. Number 7. Parks and Gardens. Paris is full of beautiful city parks and gardens where you can walk, jog, read a book, or simply soak in the atmosphere and experience the Parisian lifestyle. Some of the best gardens include the Tuileries Garden, is located just next to the Louvre Museum and was a popular meeting place for Parisians in the 19th and 20th century. Luxembourg Gardens was created in 1612 as the Garden of the Luxembourg Palace. Public park. for a while. Take a walk and explore the numerous streets of this vast, over 100-acre cemetery full of Gothic graves, burial chambers, and ancient mausoleums. The cemetery contains 70,000 burial plots. Number 9. La Défense Business District. La Défense is Europe's largest business district, containing many of Paris' tallest buildings and a large shopping mall with numerous restaurants and movie theaters. La Défense features an impressive modern architectural masterpiece, La Grande Arche, a 364-foot-tall cubical high-rise, mimicking the shape of Arc de Triomphe. You can visit La Grande Arche observation deck and see that the building is perfectly aligned with the Arc de Triomphe located in Paris City Center, over 2 miles away. Number 10. Versailles. Palace of Versailles.
Seaside cliffs and views of the misty coastline. One of the coolest places in Big Sur is the Bixby Creek Bridge. It's one of California's most photographed bridges, and you'll understand why I went there. Big Sur is also home to the Gateway Mountain, the to be one of my favorite cities. I just love how it's built right on the Puget Sound, contrasted with a skyline full of skyscrapers and a backdrop of a massive mountain range. One place you gotta visit and bring you out of high place is a public market that can open for more than 100 years, with full of fresh produce stands, new shops, and a world first Starbucks. I just love all the colors, smells, and just all around vibes. Is the Nepali coast. There are very few places in the world, if any, that match the beauty of this coastline. The Nepali coast is filled with sea cliffs that rise 3,000 feet from the ocean, contrasted with deep narrow valleys that are the There's several ways to experience the Nepali coast, and the best way is by helicopter. Prices range from anywhere between $200 and $300 for a 50-minute tour. You'll be able to get some of the best views in the world, coastal cliffs, and valleys. Another way is via boat tour, which ranges between nicknamed the Grand Canyon of the Pacific, it's over 10 miles long and 3,000 feet deep. I just love the contrast between the red rock against the tropical vegetation. After exploring the Hawaiian Islands, we're gonna head back to the continental U.S. to visit the iconic New York City, with its massive skyscrapers, diverse cultures, and the hustle and bustle atmosphere. It's a place that you need to experience. I was fortunate enough to live in New York for a few months, and the city lifestyle quickly drew on me. One of my favorite places in the city is the Brooklyn Bridge. The Brooklyn Bridge is one of the most photogenic places in all of New York. This massive bridge that connects the borough of Brooklyn to Manhattan was established in 1883 and became one of Europe's most popular attractions. As you were walking across the bridge and enjoying the view of Manhattan and the Bridgeway, the bridge is a great place to explore for a day and to see even more from the view because of the beautiful city. It seems like it's one of the most beautiful places in New York City. The Bridgeway is one of the world's most popular tourist attractions. Just such a fascinating region. The most populous city in New England is Boston. located in the state of Massachusetts, Boston is one of the oldest municipalities in the U.S., founded in 1630 by the Puritan settlers. Historical events such as the Boston Tea Party took place during the Revolutionary War here. The day Boston was a founding city, come to universities such as Harvard and MIT. But once you see the city, it's just a nature. I suggest going to Vermont. This may be one of the best places to visit during fall. Like it never ends. The final destination on the Keys takes you to the city of Key West. It's the most southern place in the continental U.S. We spent the sunset swimming on Fort Zachary Taylor State Park Beach, and it was just the perfect way to end the day. All right, after Florida, we're gonna head over to Wyoming to visit Yellowstone National Park. I went here a few weeks ago, and it was a magical experience. Now, one of the most famous places in Yellowstone is the Grand Prismatic Spring. It's the third largest hot spring in the world, with a depth of 160 feet, and from above, it displays a remarkable rainbow color. You can walk on the platform around the spring, and you'll get the best view by taking the short hike of the Grand Prismatic Spring overlook. Another iconic spot in the park is Old Faithful. It's one of the world's most famous geysers because of its reliability. It erupts around every 90 minutes, and the boiling water can reach 185 feet high. It also makes a drive up to the Alder Falls. It's one of the most powerful waterfalls I've ever seen. And it left halfway to a just a stunning spot in the mountain storm. I went there 15 in the morning, and it was magical with all of mist coming off the hot sea coast. While we're still in Wyoming, we're going to head out to the nearby there. I just had to jump the water. I have to say it was some of the coldest I've ever been in, but nothing makes you feel more alive than a polar plunge in some glacier water. If you want a more relaxed experience in the Tetons, you can take the ferry across Jenny's Lake and then make a short hike up to the waterfall. Now, after Wyoming, we're going to make the 2-hour drive to Idaho to visit the St. Anthony's Sand Dunes. I mean, this place is bizarre. It's over 10,000 acres of sand dunes right next to some farmland, and it just feels so out of place. But the whole area is the ultimate playground. Some of the dunes reach 400 feet high. Now, if you love riding dune buggies or dirt bikes, this is the place you gotta go. My grandparents live nearby, so I've come here many times. Whenever I'm here, I feel like I'm in Dubai or somewhere exotic, which is such an epic place. Idaho, we're going down to Utah to visit the famous Idaho Southwest. The Southwest are located about 2 hours west of Southern City. It's one of the prettiest locations in Utah and the world. It's basically I'm not afraid of the dark. helping me out with the footage here. He has some amazing shots of Ship Rock. What I think is so unique about it is the volcanic spines that lead up to the rock. From a new Earth point of view, you can see three volcanic spines that all come together at the rock. I mean, I've never seen anything like it before. The rock is sacred to the Navajos. They named it the Rock of the Plains. Southwest, we're going to visit Lake Powell, and Lake Powell is one of the most man-made lakes in the world. The reservoir that is located in they call it America's Lost National Park. It's currently in the Grand Canyon, except for the fill up of water. And Lake Powell was created back in 1960. A lot of my family and friends will like the Powell to go rolling down there for a week in the summertime. It's can't think of a better place for a recording, and it's up to you guys. Right outside the town, Orchard Bend, it's this picturesque section of the Colorado River surrounded by massive cliff walls. Another really fascinating nearby attraction is Antelope Canyon. It's located just 20 minutes from Orchard Bend, where Antelope Canyon is one of the most impressive slot canyons in the realm. From the outside, the area just looks like a normal desert landscape. As you descend in the slot canyon, you're witnessing one of the most beautiful sculpted sandstone. The canyon was formed by flash floods and thousands of years of erosion. But for our last destination, we're going back to Utah to visit Zion National Park. The Zion is just out of this world. If you're in the video, don't do it justice. It's from the steep red rock cliffs that are in the area. One of my favorite and most beautiful places in Zion is the Hedgehog Valley. It's about a 3 mile round trip hike that's famous for its sketchy cave dwelling. Across the bridge from the river, and it ends up in the well. Let me know what your favorite place is in the United States. Comment below. I also started a relaxation channel where I post how long ago fun music to bring some peace and nature in your life. You can find me on TikTok and Instagram at Shirley.films. It's Ryan, and we will see you later.
You watch when I was so broke. but please listen. I think I might have lost my way. Hey, look around, tell me what you see. Cause I see eternity, and I fear it's gonna swallow me. So tell me where to return to after the fall. Everything is ending around me, still I go on. Anybody out there somewhere, I swear, where am I supposed to go? Never getting nowhere in this nightmare. Welcome to the great unknown. Everything is empty, never ending. Why do I wanna fall alone? Gotta get
Thank you.